Good evening, everyone. Today, I, Rupal Roy, student of Amity University, Noida, Uttar Pradesh, pursuing my BSc Honours in Forensic Science, going to present my views on topic Ted Bundy, a case related to bite marks. Moving to slides, introduction. Nowadays, committing crime is a very casual thing. So for that, the good knowledge of evidences help us to deal with the heinous crimes. As bite marks is encountered as one of the most important and valuable evidence in the famous Ted Bundy case. As we know, that is, neither two fingers can be identical in the same way, nor two teeth can be identical with each other. As for the definition, bite marks are those marks which made by the teeth may be alone or may be with the combination of the whole. Bite marks are, as an evidence, mostly encountered in violent crimes such as in sexual offenses, homicides, child abuse cases, rape cases, etc. Here in this figure, we can see a bite mark with AVFO scale. And these bite marks should be photographed precisely, otherwise it may get distorted and may cause harm and make it less evident. Moving to next slide. Bite mark analysis and identification. To analyze that the injury is bite marks or not, then to identify it is caused by humans or non-humans. Bite marks identification is basically giving individuality of dentition. The most important step in bite mark analysis is to know the pattern injury. So by comparing the bite marks, which includes the examination of shape, size, position of individual teeth, which provide the individuals information about the suspect or an offender and relate the person who is involved in the crime. Seven types of bite marks are there, which includes hemorrhage, a small bleeding spot, abrasion, undamaging mark on skin, contusion, ruptured blood vessels, bruises, laceration, a near puncture of skin, incision, neat punctured or torn skin, avulsion, removal of skin, artifact, bitten of piece of body. Now moving to next slide. Here I'm going to discuss about the case study, the famous case study, Ted Bundy, the murderous mind. So Bundy's background and early life. As we all know, Bundy is one of the most heinous serial killer ever in history, which has been identified through bite mark analysis. On January 24, 1989, he was executed in Florida's electric chair, and shortly before his execution, he was confessed of killing 30 plus women. In early childhood of Ted, his grandfather was an extremely violent as well as aggressive person. After living in this type of environment, so normally this affected Ted a lot. He started putting knife under his pillow, and which made him a silent psychopath. Modus operandi and victim's profile. Ted was very calculating criminal who used his knowledge of law enforcement strategies for identification and capture. His victim count has risen to 20 before it became clear that almost every investigator was hunting the same person. His basic modus operandi was blunt trauma and strangulation that could be accomplished with common household items. He used to avoid firearms to the noise and the ballistic evidence they left behind. He looked for safe sites to seize and dispose of victims. Another significant obstacles for investigators were Ted's anonymous physical appearance and a thoughtful chameleon-like ability to change his appearance. Now moving forward, list of evidences. And as we all know, in that time, DNA was not as much as important or as much as approved like it is today. So that's why it was one of the biggest reason that Ted was out of conviction so long. But in that time, bite mark played a very important role on this case. So on 1979, he came into conviction. Here in this figure, we can see two women named as Lisa Levy and Bowman and Martha Bowman. So they both were the Bundy's latest victims. So during investigation, investigators collected number of evidences such as semen samples, blood samples, shoe prints, etc. But all were inconclusive. Later, they found bite marks on the buttock and the breast side of the breast part of the Lisa Levy. So after the examination, Bundy's teeth samples were matched with the bite marks of the bite marks, as doctors has focused the size of the teeth and the sharpness of the bicuspids, central incisors, lateral incisors, and the shape of the canines. Here we can see the casting image of Ted Bundy's teeth. Here we can see the lateral and central incisor canines and bicuspids, how they are formed. So by this crooked shape of teeth, it can be easily identified for the investigators to identify Ted Bundy. Now moving forward to the next slide. Review of literature. Here I'm going through various research papers, and I got to know, I found two of them, that is Brian Plote on May 1, 2000. He gave some views on Ted Bundy case. According to him, he thought that right from the day he was born, Ted Bundy was basically living a false life. He was not Theodore Robert Cole as he was at his birth, nor he Theodore Robert Nelson as he was when his name was legally changed. The entire time he was Ted Bundy, the demented serial killer who got his thrills through brutal torturing and tormenting beautiful young women. Now the name Ted Bundy will forever be synonymous with murder. Another research paper, that is Ted Bundy, the Bite, from Caleb Colony, Cumberland University. Here, in this case of Ted Bundy, we see how forensic odontology was crucial in both investigation and conviction of a prolific killer. However, the use of this field of forensic science would not have been possible without the systematic crime scene processing. Integral to a forensic investigation in judicial collection, documentation, and processing of physical evidence, processing crime scenes must be done in a methodical manner to ensure that no stone is left unturned. Dutiful crime scene processing and excellent photographic evidence proved to be utmost importance to the case against Bundy. Now, moving to the conclusion part, basically we see here that what we need first, it is important to identify the bite marks, then the proper documentation of the bite marks, and then comparison of bite marks. These are the three key rules. So bite marks either done by the victim to protect oneself, or it is done by the culprit. As it is probably done for... One second. As it is probably forms U-shaped arches, and through this, it can identify whether the victim is alive or dead. During the delivery of a bite marks on the body, it can be measured by ABFO scale, that is American Board of Forensic Odontologists scale, and the bite marks can be collected through mainly photography, recording, swabbing techniques, tissue samples, etc. The bite marks as an evidence is a very vital in case of Ted Bundy case, which was well-known case and that shocked Americans all across the country. Though cases like Ted Bundy help us to give insight into the minds and reasoning behind the serial killers, their modus operandi, and many more. It depicts how he became the violent and most heinous serial killer of his era. Thank you.